connect. Today we are going to discuss about the rest of the Schneider instructions. So you can put a contact right here. Then I have to go for the FIFO or LIFO registers. I'll take the FIFO or LIFO. First thing FIFO. FIFO means first in, first out. I have to change the FIFO from here to LIFO also. Okay, I'm just only doing the FIFO. First in, first out. And the last in, first out. So first in, first out, I have to use the three contacts from here. For reset, for feeding the values into the FIFO, it's I, and retrieving the value O. And we have two outputs, one is empty and one is full. Have to put two coils for the FIFO also, for the empty and the full. Then the address I0.0, I0.1, I0.2, and here we go. Q0.0, Q0.1. So that's it. Then we can go for the runtime. So for feeding the value, we have to go for the watch table or the animation table. So I'm going to run this. Then go to the tools and make a new animation table from here. And have created an animation table, and I have to feed the value that will be inside a register named %r0.i. So I have to use %r0.i. This is the input register for the FIFO and r0.o for the output register for the FIFO. And we run the runtime and have to feed the values. File and have to toggle the I input. I have to input the value which I have fitted to the r0.i, and you can see the empty bit of the FIFO register has been on. I have to toggle it 1, and we can see the empty has been gone because 5 has been fitted to the FIFO. Then have to toggle it back and have to change the value to 10. Again toggle on and off. Again I have to change the value 15, again toggle, and last one 20, again toggle the input. So four values I have fed, 5, 10, 15 and 20. To retrieve the values, I have to toggle our pulse to the retrieval bit or the I0.2, and the retrieved values will be shown in the %r0.o. I have to toggle the second output, so the second input. One first value has been first in, first out. The first feed value 5 has been fed to the output. Two again, I am going to toggle. You can see 10, and the next will be 15, and the last one will be 20. While getting the 20, you can see that empty bit has been again appeared. That's the FIFO register. So we can go back to the edit mode and let's go for the next function block. That will be a bit shift register. Okay, we are going to explain the bit shift or the shift bit register. The timers we already discussed in the previous class. So I have to delete this and go for the bit shift register. Just place the bit shift register and deleting all this stuff. By taking the eraser, I have to delete all the things. All things I am going to delete. Then back, and you can see %SBR0 is the address for the shift bit register. You can go for the runtime. And I don't need the %R0.I anymore because I'm not using the FIFO register anymore. So you can go and delete this, both of them. And I have to use the %RSBR0.0, that is the first input address for the shift bit register. SBR0.0, that is the first bit address, and 0.1 and 0.2. I am using only 2. I can use up to 16 registers. Up to SBR0.15 I can use. So let's reset. A countdown is available for the shift bit register. So I'm using value 1, making 1, and you can see the shift bit register. The first bit has been turned 1, and when I am toggling the count of CU with I0.1, you can see that will be shifting to the next bit. Okay, that will be when I am toggling count up, that will be shifting to the next bits. Okay, you can see that will be shifting to the left sides, and have to, if you want to count down, have to use the I0.2 for the counting down. By pressing that, that will be coming back to the previous positions. Okay, that will be shifting to the back positions. That is the count up and count down shift bit register. Have to use a 1 in the first memory bit. That is the SBR, and I'm going to use the R means that's the reset, and I'm going to use the next one, that will be step counter. Step counter I'm going to use here. Okay, the step counter has been used, and I'm going to launch the simulator. So the percentage SBR 0.0 and 0.1, I don't have to use it anymore, and for the runtime, and you can see all this stuff. I'm deleting these things, and I have to use the percentage SC 0.0. That is the address for the step counter. SC 0.0, that is first address. SC 0.1, that is second one, and SC 0.2, that's the third one. You can see by default it contains at the SC 0.0, the first bit, memory bit. You can see the value is 1. Okay, we don't have to provide any value, or we don't have to make any value as 1 like in the shift bit register. The step counter always have a value, and we just want to go for the up count and down count and raise it only. For up counting, we have to use the I0.1 on and off. You can see that value will be counting in the upward direction automatically when I'm pressing the countdown. Okay, and by pressing the countdown, that will be coming back to the previous position. And again, I'm making it a up counting. And if I press the reset button, the value will not be gone off, and that will be came to the previous position when I'm resetting the step counter or the that's it. Then I'm going to use the drum sequencer in the next video. I'm using the drum sequencer and the user defined function blocks. It's a wholesome topic, so we can discuss in the next sessions. So hope you enjoyed. Thank you.